Hey, how's it going? It's Red Champ here. Just wanted to go over a couple changes from NHL 21 to 22. A lot of new players are moving over, and a lot of the builds have had some small changes to them, such as the power forward's body checking has been drastically increased from its base 21 counterpart. It now starts at 86, but you're also at 77 speed. And that's because this year you can add plus 5 by taking away 5 from another point. They all have different costs to them. So say you wanted to take 30 away from 81, right? You get 30 points, but it's only 20 for slap shot accuracy. So in order to hit the 40 speed for that cost, those 2 points equal the 1 point. So that's how this is going to work for that. Overall, it makes for a very good system, but let's get back to the video at hand. We'll start off by showing the Dangler class and its base abilities, as well as its zone ability and everything that's available to it. So the Dangler starts at 5'11", 185. It's a pretty solid height not to get knocked around at, but as you notice this year, you get 85 speed, which is the case for most of the base offensive classes. You're no longer starting at 88 or 89. Like, if you drop yourself all the way down to 5'7", 160, and be the lightest you can possibly be, in 21, you'd have 90 speed or a little bit above. Now you're capped out. So you see you only get 88 there. And this adds a little bit more balance to it, because if it was the same as 21, you would have absolutely unmatched speed. But what this also does this year is you're able to change the inches of your guy for his height, and you don't lose as many stats. So from 5'7 to 5'9, even 5'10, like, there's very minimal change for your speed, your acceleration, and your agility. And what that lets you do is make a bigger player while not suffering the consequences for being big. But now let's get into the zone abilities for it. So the zone ability for the Dangler starts with Puck on a String. As you play World of Chell, you'll level up some more abilities. If you bought the X-Factor pre-order edition, you do get some abilities for free. I believe it's Magnetic and Elite Edges, as well as some that are shared in different classes. So like the two-way forward, the defenseman, two-way defenseman, I mean. And from there, you get some pretty good abilities right off the start that you don't have to unlock. But the thing about these gold abilities is you do not have to meet the requirements for them. So if you go into your superstar ability, see if I want to use Ankle Breaker here, I need to meet a minimum of 75 deking and 82 agility, which is fine. But if I'm to put that on the Dangler as a zone ability, I don't need to. I can just click that. So now I'm below the 90 required deking, right? I can still use Ankle Breaker, which is good for people who don't know that little trick yet. Now, with the abilities, the gold versions are far superior to their silver counterparts. So having a gold close quarters will be far more effective
than a silver close quarters ability.
As you can see here, it says advanced power and accuracy when taking wrist shots slash slap snapshots in close proximity to the net. Whereas on the gold version, it is exceptional power and accuracy when taking wrist slash snapshots in close proximity to the net. Fuck, I just can't talk. Okay, so back to the topic at hand. The Dangler's abilities are Puck on a String, exceptional toe drag and stick handling speed, also excels at low speed deeks. This is a solid ability that lets you do some pretty quick toe drags and can complement your stick handling left-rights, even if your deking stat is relatively low. Now, Ankle Breaker is an amazing ability. Exceptional ability to deke opponents at top speed. So when you're skating full bore, this lets you pull off your dekes without slowing down as much. So normally if you put it on your forehand, you immediately slow head down, put it on your backhand. As soon as you start deking, your speed starts to decrease. Ankle Breaker lets you just jam out and keep everything going and pull some quick moves off without a huge penalty. Magnetic, super, super strong skill. You get bad passes, you pick them up, pick up the pucks off the board good, and it's just overall a great ability, and it compensates for your lack of hand-eye, if you have a lack of hand-eye, I should say. So say you're playing a sniper, you got 80 base hand die. There's going to be passes that your guy just fumbles just because. With Magnetic, that doesn't happen anymore. Elite Edges, one of the best abilities in the games for threes. You have get exceptional maneuverability with the ability to turn tight corners while retaining high speed. So what this means is you're going to go in, burn a defender, cut hard, and still retain your speed. One little thing to note with this is if you do like a little stutter step and quickly change the direction of your analog stick, you will get like a quick speed boost in the direction that you want to go. Next is Close Quarters. This one is a staple to the Dangler. The Dangler doesn't get the highest shot, but to make him deadly, this is what you want to use. Like, you can come in with Ankle Breaker, Elite Edges, and Puck on a String and just dangle the shit out of anybody. But when you don't have the room to do all that, and you just need to be able to snipe, but you still want those quick hands and the shifty ability of the Dangler, Close Quarters is your skill. Alright, so with that, let's take a look at the base stats. They're pretty self-explanatory. The Dangler starts at 5'11", 185. So here's the base stats for that. Next, we'll head into the Defensive Defenseman. Now, I have a buddy who plays Defensive Defenseman. This isn't my class. I'm an offensive player. If I play D, I'm using a puck mover or a grinder because their defensive ability is phenomenal. That being said, I'd probably just play my sniper on the point for the shot. Like, I can move the puck around just as well. If you make the smart plays, like, you'll be okay. So the Defensive Defenseman starts at 6'4", 220. Its main zone ability is Stick 'Em Up. You get phenomenal defensive stick speed, exceptional accuracy when poke checking against momentum or speed. So this one works really well because chances are somebody is always moving, which is perfect. So this one's always going to be active, pretty much. Next is Shutdown. Happens quite often that you get left alone, your teammates are gone, and you're left one-on-one. Or you're going to fight in the corner, and there's enough distance between you and everyone else that this is considered a one-on-one. It doesn't always have to be on the rush, which is great for when you're going into the corners to fight, because you get stronger hitting strength on the one-on-one situations. Next is Bouncer. This one is super strong and very, very underutilized. I don't see a lot of people using this build, but it has about the same distance to close quarters, and it's exceptional at battles around the net. Greatly increases stability, stick tension, and limb strength around the net. Opposing players also take longer to recover from net battles. So this ability just lets you be dominant in the slot. You're able to fight for the puck better. It's a lot like No Contest, except when you get into net battles with this, you win. It's an amazing ability. Truculence, one of my favorite abilities. This is amazing for a lot of reasons. One of them is that you can play an offensive class, jack up your hitting, and you can knock over some big boys with this ability. So you get exceptional stability and assist on hits, meaning it'll help pull you into hits if they do a cut, and it greatly increases their chance of knocking over the opponent and sapping their energy. So the sapping of the energy is great because you want to tire them out when you hit them. You want them to get penalized for you running them over. Next, the chance of knocking over an opponent is great. There's nothing better than just dump an opponent on his ass and he's out of the play. It's perfect. And it's a very accessible skill too. You just need some acceleration and some body checking. Next is Quick Pick. This skill has been very underwhelming for me this year, and I find that there's a lot better abilities than this one. I would take Stick 'Em Up 10 times out of 10 before I took Quick Pick. Now, not to say it's a horrible ability, in theory, it's amazing. But the way it functions in this game just hasn't been up to par for what I think a zone ability should be. So that's the Defensive Defenseman. He's 6'4", 220. These are all of his base stats. They're pretty solid overall. He's got very strong stick checking and defensive awareness. The body checking is the same as the power forward, same as the strength. But it's important to note that all of these abilities here can be increased by 5. So when you're considering that, defensive awareness and stick checking, both of these abilities can go up to 99. So see, stick checking's 95. We'll just slap on some stick checking here. 99 stick checking. Okay. Now there's a couple classes that can do stuff like this. Dangler can have 99 DKing, Playmaker can have 99 passing. And obviously defensive defenseman can have 99 stick checking and 99 defensive awareness, which is an interesting theory on how to build it. Now, there's no way to get it perfect because you're gonna not have enough points. So see that I'm down 70, I have to take some away. So one can be 96 and the other can be 99 between both of them basically. So next we're gonna go to the offensive defenseman. The offensive defenseman starts at 6'1", 200. Its main zone ability is Thunderclap, which is a phenomenal ability if you have time to wind up at the point. There's nothing more to say about it. It's a great skill. It's especially powerful paired with Off the Rush and paired with Seeing Eye. Now, Off the Rush is a ability that lets you play like Make It Snappy, which is another ability in this game. It's basically when you flick the puck with Make It Snappy, you get a hard flick. So the thing with Off the Rush is you get a hard slapper when you're skating. Now on the point, you're not gonna be too mobile to take the shot, but it is nice to have the extra oomph added in, and having a stacking ability with Thunderclap and Off the Rush paired with Seeing Eye means when you're rotating around the zone and you hit that perfect angle when everyone's screened, you're probably scoring. Next, Heatseeker. It's get exceptional power and accuracy when taking wrist/snapshots from a distance. It's pretty strong. It can be paired with Make It Snappy because it says a snapshot. So with that, you can be at the point just lobbing quick bombs and they will be piss missiles from the point. Next is Seeing Eye. This is one of my favorite abilities. So Seeing Eye has exceptional power and accuracy on shots when the goalie is screened. A screened goalie's reaction time is also greatly reduced when shooting with this ability. Nothing is better than lowering the goalie's reaction time and save ability, because that's something they can't control. Doesn't matter if they're in perfect position, you're reducing their ability to make a save, which is fantastic when paired with some other skills. As long as you have a good teammate who knows how to screen and can get to the net and they're not just all waiting at the side for the perfect pass over, then you can make this work. But this ability gains more and more power the more people are on the ice. In threes, you're only gonna have a couple people in front of the net. But when you're playing sixes, chances are there's a good amount of bodies crowding the net, and it's gonna be tough for the goalie to make a save, as long as you can get that puck through, which relies on your own ability to find the lanes to shoot. Next is No Contest. Exceptional stick tension and strength when going into pickups, resulting in more wins battling for the puck. This ability, I've seen a couple people use it. I've used it for myself at the start of the season. It is phenomenal. So body position is super key in NHL 22, and it's handy to be able to just skate into somebody and you're picking the puck up off them. Like, you get those battles along the boards when you're skating into each other and you're fumbling and trying to get the puck. You're coming out with that puck with this ability. Next is 1T. I made a video about this not too long ago, and this ability is so strong. It is absolutely one of my favorite abilities in the game. And this pairs very well with Thunderclap and Seeing Eye. Because if you have a screened guy in front and you're taking a one-timer from the side and you're far enough out to get the bonus from Thunderclap, this is a absolute bomb. Think of it in the sense of you're bombing shots like Shea Weber or Ovechkin, but back him up another 10 feet so he's not at the top of the circle. Following that, it greatly increases the ability to one time from less than ideal passes. So what that means is if your buddy gives you a shit pass and normally your guy would fumble it, this just says, hey, I'm good at one timers, I'm gonna take this puck and hammer it regardless of how bad your pass is, which is great. So again, the offensive defenseman is 6'1", 200 pounds, and overall its strengths are pretty spread out across the board, but you can reach a maximum of 94 slapshot power, and that's pretty strong overall, because you can have 90-90 on both your accuracy as well, which just makes you an exceptional shooting threat. However, one thing I tested with my buddy is that you can make a defensive sniper with the boosts and have a super hard shot from the point with better shooting and a smidge better mobility. Now you have less defensive ability, but you can at least get one of these stats up to 80, and that'll help you in the long run anyways. That's more of a threes thing. Next, we got the Enforcer Defenseman. Now, you don't see too many people playing this. It's super fun in ones, it's strong, but it gets burned. It's definitely something that you need to play in like sixes when it's a little more crowded out there. Again, it seems the common theme is you start at 86 body checking and 86 strength. So that being said, that means you get your maximum up to 95. But here's the deal. You can increase your weight and your height to change your abilities. So what's to say you can't have 99 body checking or 99 strength? Like, is that not ridiculous? Every class can do something like this, but just having the ability to be like, yeah, 99 body checking, you're toast. You're not gonna have a power forward who can stand up to you. That is absolutely massive. Now, obviously, as you increase your height and weight, you take some more penalties to your speed, your acceleration, and your agility, as well as your endurance. But let's go back to the zone abilities here. The Bouncer, we talked about this one, exceptional at battles around the net, greatly increases stability, stick tension, and limb strength around the net. Opposing players also take longer to recover from net battles. Solid ability for a defenseman, especially if you're tying up, because you tie them up, leave them, they're still sitting there like a dumbass for a little bit. Next is Truculence. One of my favorite abilities. It's nice that this has it. So the hitting classes, enforcers basically, get some really good abilities to compensate for their lack of actual ability. Unstoppable force, exceptional strength of the puck, and greatly increased ability to hold on the puck when off balance. So I, for the life of me, can't make this work properly, but one of my buddies, Deadly, on Slaughterhouse, whose team is like 78-8 right now, these guys, he plays a power forward, and he is ridiculously hard to get the puck off with this. So anytime you're off balance, somebody shoved you, you've just lost the puck, or you're doing a turn or something like that, you have exceptional strength and a greatly increased ability to hold on to the puck, which is fantastic. Makes it really hard to get the puck off them. So if somebody's playing like a 5'7 sniper, 160, and they're trying to be speedy, you're not getting the puck off this guy. He's just gonna skate through you. Speaking of skating through you, back at you. Ability enables player to reverse hit opponents, maximize damage, and retain balance. Chance to knock opponents off balance is greatly increased. You pair this with Truculence, you're running everybody over. So how you do a reverse hit is whenever somebody comes to hit you, you tap your X or A button and it'll enable you to just run them over. Next is No Contest. We've been there, we've talked about this. Exceptional stick tension and strength when going into pickups, resulting in more wins when battling for the puck. Overall, pretty solid. These are the Enforcer's base stats. Obviously, its strongest points are its body checking and its strength, both starting at 86. However, one thing to note, it has very high durability, which means you're not going to get injured that frequently. And you can take away these points and easily put them somewhere else for something good. Next, let's head into the two-way defenseman. 6'2", 205 is its starting weight. Quick pick is its main zone ability you get off the start. Talked about it. I'm not a fan of it. It has great potential, but I don't think it's working the way that it should. No Contest. Talked about it. As you're starting to see, a lot of these classes are branching in between classes, and that's where you're going to find the balance between the builds. You might want to play a Dangler, but you find you can make a playmaker exactly like a Dangler, but with different abilities than what you wanted, which is something I first started with my Sniper. I made a Sniper that could dangle. He had 88 deking. He was able to shoot really hard, hang onto the puck, pull off the moves that I wanted, and that was enough for me. So next we got Stick 'Em Up. Same old, talked about it. Phenomenal defensive stick, exceptional accuracy when poke checking against momentum or speed, greatly reduces the chance of a penalty. shutdown, the one-on-ones, hitting in the corners, exceptional accuracy when poke-checking against momentum or speed at a one-on-one, and also greatly improved shot blocking. It's super, super handy. Heat Seeker. So this is to give the two-way defenseman a little bit of offensive viability. So remember how we talked about having seeing eye and being able to flick from the point with make it snappy? Heat Seeker pairs very well with those abilities because you are just able to bomb shots from the point. So think of it in the sense that you're on the line, you're about to lose the puck, you flick it, you're shooting that puck as hard as a slap shot. It's super, super amazing. It's really strong ability. So the two-way defenseman is solid all around. Most of its stats are all in the 80s. There's a few that drop below, but what you can do with everything is the subtract 5, add 5, as long as you meet the total stat weight. You're not going to be able to take 10 away from here, get 50 points, and then put a bunch of points in for 30. That's not how it's going to work. But the two-way defenseman is pretty strong overall. It's very balanced. I do think there are better classes out there, but this certainly meets a lot of things that you can do. Being that most of its stats are in the 80s, it lets you very easily change a few stat points here and there to meet the requirements for the superstar abilities that you want. So, advanced ability for Ankle Breaker. You want a two-way defenseman with Ankle Breaker? Sure. 2 points off there. Now we're able to use Ankle Breaker, right? Next, we got the Puck Moving Defenseman. So, the Puck Moving Defenseman is my favorite defenseman this year. It starts at 6'190", has some pretty amazing abilities in it. So, Send It is a large increase to pass assist with exceptional ability to auto sauce long passes. So, if you're coming over from 21 and you're struggling to pass, this is probably ability you want. You get it very early on, and I think people dump it too quick when they unlock new superstar abilities. And it's super strong, and I think it goes under the radar just a little bit. People like to pick tape to tape over it instead, but I think this one can really help out. Next is Magnetic. We talked about this. You get exceptional skill at picking up pucks at speed, corralling bouncing or rolling pucks, and reeling in less than ideal passes. Super good to keep your momentum, not fumble the puck. It's great. Now here we go. Seeing Eye, exceptional power and accuracy on shots when the goalie is screened. A screen goalie's reaction time is also greatly reduced when shooting with this ability. It's a perfect ability, it works great. Just make sure your teammates go to the front of the net. Tape to tape, this is the ability that is broken this year to most people. I don't use it personally, I find I don't need it. I'll make my passes regardless of having this ability in. It is exceptional power and accuracy on auto saucer and backhand passes within this vision. So the way this is written, you would think that, oh, you're only getting exceptional power and accuracy on auto saucer passes and backhand passes within your field of vision. However, this skill goes off even when you're on the forehand. So take it for what you will. It's just a great passing ability as long as you can see that your passer or your player that you're passing to. Next is Elite Edges. This is one of the reasons why this build is so good. The puck moving defenseman gets exceptional maneuverability with the ability to turn tight corners while retaining high speed. So a lot of the defensemen this year feel very slow and you can make them feel mobile, but the puck moving defenseman starts at 85 speed, meaning you can make this just as good as any offensive forward build. So the Dangler, the Playmaker, the Sniper, all those builds that can have 92, 93 speed, Puck Mover can do it too. Though I find that 92, 92 is perfect for this build and really lets you just navigate around. One thing that most people haven't considered yet that I've seen is putting a Puck Moving Defenseman on the wing. So there's a few variations between Puck Moving Defenseman and the Playmaker. But the puck moving defenseman has stronger defensive stats. And I think when you build it overall, I think it works pretty well on the wing compared to the playmaker. That's my personal preference on it. I would always prefer to run a puck moving defenseman on the side rather than a playmaker, just for the added defensive abilities. But with this class, If you are a center, you are losing 5 faceoffs right out of the bat. So the max you'll be able to have is 85 faceoffs, which if you're playing center, chances are your buddy that you're going against there is going to have at least 85 to 90, because they start at 85. Unless they are an absolute dunce and take their faceoffs down to 80 for more deking right off the bat when they're playing center, then, you know, you'll be fine. But we don't talk about those people. They're a different breed. Next, we got the grinder. This build is super unorthodox. It's very strong despite its stat layout. And if you know how to play a grinder well with a good forecheck and just being the greasy goals in front of the net, this build will work out great for you. So the grinder starts out at 6'1", 205, and actually has the highest based hand eye in the game. You can get this up to 95 when everything's all said and done with boosts and plus fives. It's for starting zone ability is no contest, followed by stick 'em up. Totally clips. We haven't gone over this one yet. This is one of the ones that pairs extremely well with seeing eye. I made a video on this a little earlier. When these two are paired together, it's so easy to score. So Total Eclipse has exceptional skill at screening the goalie and obstructing their view. While screening this player, the goalie's reaction time is greatly reduced. So you park your big ass in front of that goalie, you're gonna score. Next is Crease Crasher. Underrated ability, super, super strong. It's kinda niche because you have to get the puck off rebounds, but you know what? I rarely miss when I use this ability, and if you're playing a human goalie, chances are they're not saving it. It's already in the net before they can react. So you get exceptional ability to crowd bouncing pucks off rebounds, meaning if the puck kicks out super far out of your reach, chances are you'll scoop it. Greatly increases shot accuracy on rebounds too. Pairs very, very well with close quarters because you're already going to be in the crease, which is going to give you that bonus to your shot power and your accuracy. And then this is going to give you even more accuracy. So despite the fact that you might have 78 or 80 accuracy on the grinder, you're probably going to shoot like you have 90 when you have those two abilities on. Next is Big Tipper. Exceptional speed, accuracy, and range when deflecting shots. So the cool thing about this is it pairs very, very well with the fact that the grinder can have 95 hand eye. It's a perfect combination. There is better abilities than Big Tipper. I'm probably recommending this one more as your superstar if you were to use it, rather than your main one. And I do think that No Contest and Stick 'em Up are the strongest abilities. But you know what? It's also very rare that you see Total Eclipse and Crease Crasher. These are the only ones that when you're playing a class, you're not too, how do I put it? The grinder isn't great offensively, and these two abilities can greatly make up for it by providing something that's not offensive, but contributes to the team. So overall, right off the bat, the strongest thing for the grinder is its stick checking. It's super, super strong. You know what we can do with 88 stick checking? That goes straight down. You're at 93. You're putting the plus 4 on there. Guess what? You got 97 stick checking on the grinder. That's pretty good for a forward. Next, we're going to move into the playmaker. So, playmaker, 6 foot 190. Starts off with 90 passing, 90 offensive awareness, pretty strong. It's also able to get its deking pretty high up there too, despite being a playmaker. They normally have better than average hands, but this year you can have last year's deking, basically. So the zone ability for the playmaker is tape to tape. It is exceptional power and accuracy on saucer and backhand passes within vision. It's very good. Magnetic, great picking up the puck. Third eye. So this year you find that when you're not looking at the player you're passing to, your passes are going to be off. This is huge. So when you're playing 21 and you're cycling the puck behind you, you can't see the person that's there, but it's still going to them perfectly. This is the ability you want, paired with one or two of the other ones, so that you can make those same passes you made in 21. If you can adapt to the new system this year. Puck on a string. Exceptional toe drag and stick handling speed. Also excels at low speed deeks. It's amazing ability. Super, super good. Elite edges. You know the drill. It's great. One of the best abilities in the game. Perfect for threes. Helps keep your speed. Exceptional maneuverability with the ability to turn tight corners while retaining high speed. Very, very strong. So, playmaker, 85 speed, 85 agility, 85 acceleration. Meaning that once you drop everything all the way down, you can hit that 93 speed and acceleration. I'll just show you quickly here how that works. Now, when you do that, you're always compensating a lot, but this is just to show you that that's the maximum you can reach. Now, there is an ability in the game that lets you get plus 2 speed and plus 2 acceleration. However, in order to get those, you need 77 balance, which means you're not going to have enough points unless you absolutely tank your agility and all your other shooting abilities. Just as well, there's a cap on your size. So if you're 5'7", 160, you're only reaching 74 balance. Okay, so you need to actually be bigger, which is going to lower your speed and acceleration in turn to begin with. Next, we got the sniper. This is my go-to build this year. I'm going to be starting to fool around on Dangler a little bit just to pull off some pretty goals, fool around and stuff, because I like doing the dekes. This year, I play a very simple, hard forechecking sniper. I can hit, I can run people over, and I use one-timer as my main ability. And it's been very, very successful for me. I average 4.2 points per game. Recently, we got a new winger, and I'm close to averaging 5 points a game. Give or take a game or two that we don't get, and then it lowers, but that's how it goes. So at 5'11", 185 is the base sniper. Now, sniper has the highest shooting in the game. You start off really, really good, and it only gets better. However, one thing to consider is that because the sniper's shooting is so good, you can lower it to still be better than most of the other classes and get all your speed bonuses. So you're able to just have really good mobility while having a good shot. So the sniper's main ability is make it snappy. So last year you came across the zone, you flicked it short side. You want to do that this year? Pick this ability. Otherwise, it's kind of weird because you have to make sure that you're almost skating to the side that you're shooting to make sure this goes off, because if you're just skating in a straight line and you flick it, sometimes you'll just get off a backhand shot, which means you don't get the bonus for this. Also worth noting, you have to be skating. If you're stationary and you're flicking make it snappy, it's not going to work. Close quarters, one of the strongest abilities, and you unlock it very early. Exceptional power and accuracy when taking wrist shots and snapshots in close proximity to the net. Being that you can get a 95 wrister on the sniper, this is super huge. Magnetic, exceptional skill at picking up pucks at speed, corralling, bouncing, or rolling pucks, and reeling in less than ideal passes. So the base sniper has 80 hand eye, which means hard passes, chances are they'll fumble it and then pick it up. This negates it. You don't have that problem at all. I recommend it as a silver ability though, so that you still get the benefit of just picking up the puck without fumbling it. But it opens up the fact that you could have close quarters or 1T. Next is Heatseeker. So when you're a sniper and you're a forward, you're probably not going to be shooting too much from the point or from further back than top of the circle. But if you were to play a defensive sniper on the point, say threes, or even as just wanted to be the offensive guy in sixes, this is a great ability to have, because you can have that 95 wrist shot power, stack this with Make It Snappy and Heat Seeker, and just bomb them from the point. Next is one-timer. This is my staple this year. You want to shoot like Ovechkin and Stamkos every time you hit the puck? Put this ability on. It is fantastic. So that's a sniper. Next, we're into the power forward. This year, power forwards go one of two ways. They're absolute dog shit and they're slow and you skate around them, or they are a unstoppable force. So at 6'4", 220, the zone ability for the power forward is Big Rig. It gets exceptional strength and ability when driving the net in puck protect. So you're holding the X button, you can hang on to the puck better. Stronger freehand to hold off the defender when cutting to the net. Now, as it says it's got to be in puck protect, I don't find that's the case. It can activate when you're just driving to the net. Unstoppable force. This is the ability that breaks power forward. So exceptional strength at the puck and greatly increased ability to hold onto the puck when off balance. If you're small, you can't hit, and you don't have stick checking, you are going to have a horrible time versus a power forward with unstoppable force. Next, we have off the rush. This is one of the abilities I was talking about earlier in the game, but you get exceptional power and accuracy when taking slap shots while skating. Now, the power forward has a very solid base slap shot right off the bat. It is 86. You can increase that to 91 and then put a plus 2 in it for 93. So it's overall pretty strong. Following that, the next ability is Truculence. It is the hitting one where you knock them over and get a better chance to actually put them on their ass while sapping their energy. Pretty strong, great ability. Not sure it's worth the gold ability compared to Unstoppable Force, but it's still strong. Next, you have Crease Crasher. So we talked about this one on the grinder. It is really strong. Power forward is hard to move off the puck, and it's even harder in front of the net when you're battling them. They're big, they're awkward, and they're strong, which makes it super tough to just push them around and clear the crease with them, unless you're a big defensive defenseman or an enforcer who can just shove them right out of the way. So that's the power forward, 6'4", 220. The power forward actually has the highest stat total between all of the player builds. My buddy created a spreadsheet and pulled up all the totals of the builds for what their total stats were, and it is very strong. Next, the two-way forward. So two-way forward starts at 6 foot, 200. Its main zone ability is Yoink. This is a stick checking ability, so when you hit X, that's when it'll work. Exceptional accuracy when stick checking against momentum or speed. Opposing players take much longer to recover from stick lifts. So this ability has its pros and cons. One of the main cons is you don't get to choose whether you're hooking somebody or you're stick checking when you hit the X button and you're in close to them. However, chances are this will do very well for you, but there's always the chance that you take a penalty just out of nowhere. Stick them up. It's perfect on the two-way forward. You have super high stick checking to start. It's just great. No contest. We've circled around through all these abilities. Lots of classes are sharing some of the same ones, but get different variations on their own. So no contest, exceptional stick strength and tension. When going to the pickups, chances are you come up with the puck. Heat Seeker, adding a little bit of offensive flair to the two-way forward, being that most of its stats are around the 80s. Next is Quick Pick. Exceptional at intercepting pucks off the ice. It also significantly increases the player range when intercepting pucks. However, again, see if they fix it, see if they adjust something, because I don't think it's as good as it is. Again, that's my personal opinion on it. Maybe it works amazing for you, and that's fantastic if it does, but it doesn't work the way I'd like it to on mine. So next is the Enforcer. The Enforcer is 6'6". 230, starts off with Truculence as its main ability, which is the hitting perk. The Enforcer has a lot of good perks because it doesn't have a lot of anything else. So Truculence totally clips for the screening, back at you to reverse hit everyone. Whenever they try to toss a hit, you barrel them over. No contest because you're big, you're strong, you're gonna come out with the puck. And unstoppable force because you want to be a dickhead and run people over and just not lose the puck. So it's pretty solid overall. You see the standard 86-86, which means when you put it at the max height and weight, you can get up to 99-99, which is super, super fun. And it's very satisfying to just flick the right stick and absolutely annihilate somebody. But you'll find with the Enforcer, it's best suited for ones or threes eliminator, where it's a little bit more arcadey, or you're just able to just run people over and not suffer the big open ice. And then we are back at Dangler. So that is the full loop. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Yeah, that's it. Enjoy.
Remember to like and subscribe. Thanks.